Grave. Comment le bien et le mal s'attachent ensemble?
איך הטוב והרע מתחברים?
How can the good and bad connect together?
על ידי קו האמצעי אנחנו לומדים.
By the middle line, that's how we learn. The Creator, when He appears, He can connect between us, between good and evil, only from above. Only that form that descends from above, over all the oppositions, opposites, contradictions, and they become, they complete one another.
Pourquoi jusqu'à présent on voit que à chaque fois que je sais pas s'il y a une situation mauvaise ou bien si je me sens mal, quand le bien vient, il enlève le mal. Les deux ne se connectent pas.
So why in the present state, if I have bad and all of a sudden a greater bad and all of a sudden good comes, then it moves the bad aside. They don't connect together.
Because they're not equal. They're not equal. You feel yourself from the outset in one desire called self-love. And with respect to that desire, you check and everything. And before you have a screen, restriction and a screen, you can't see anything else. Rather, you see always inside the desire to enjoy. Meaning, you have nothing objective.
Before the masach, what is my work?
Before the screen, only intermingling, integration in the group. That's the only means. There's no way to talk about anything else. Only by that, it's not that it helps you. It helps you because you draw the reforming light and it influences the group. And when you're integrated with them, by that you acquire a new quality.
How do I keep the evil? What does it mean to keep or guard the evil?
Keep the evil, meaning that you're not running away from it, but rather continue to work in the group, and you understand that without the revelation of evil, you have no vessel in which to discover the Creator.
So without a masach, without a screen, there is a...
No. Without screen, you have nothing to do. I'm sorry, but... Screen is kesef, money, cover. You have money, you can acquire. You don't have money, you cannot acquire.
What is tzimtzum? What is restriction?
Restriction means that from this moment on, you're under such an influence of the light that it doesn't let you use in order to receive.
We want to work on restriction, but what to do?
You have a tendency to do something. And there's only one thing to do. Draw the light. So which actions? Prayers, requests, study, what do I have to do in order to draw the light? There's nothing other than that. Only with the Sgula, with the remedy, with the virtue of Torah and Mitzvot. What does it mean? First Torah, which is the reforming light, and then you can perform the Mitzvot, the commandments, the actions in order to bestow.
Why acting?
But it's a help.
Yes.
Because by that, you nevertheless begin to perform actions that influence the reforming light. That's how we're built. We don't feel the system that we're in. You're constantly in billions of connections with everyone. So what does it mean that it's a lie, that when we act, we lie? It's not a lie. It's the truth. But towards us, it appears this way, because otherwise we would never play, never act. We would never play. It's like that little girl. Her mother is telling her, play with our little baby sister. She says, no, I want to play with a doll. She wants to play with a doll and not with a baby. Look at the example he's given you. If it's not for the game, you would not reach the work of the Creator. If it's a game, I'm ready to do it. It's not serious. I get some pleasure out of it. My inner lie fits this outer lie where I'm playing. But to do true actions, real actions, to play with a baby, no, I don't want it. Mother, you are doing it in order to bestow. You're in spirituality. In my world, there are only dolls made out of plastic and rags. Think about it. This is our game, our acting in the group. But in truth, do we have rag dolls? No, but it only appears to us this way. It only appears to us this way, but without this lie, I wouldn't even approach it. I wouldn't come to spirituality. There's great depth in it. We're going to go to